Bandpass Modulation. But with a couple of interesting tricks. And so, of course, it's usually used in high frequency applications, so we need to be a bit more conservative how we transmit the data, or a bit more careful maybe. So remember the IFFT generates as a signal x of n, but remember this signal x of n is complex valued. So what we have is, for example, in QAM or something like this, that we have got complex numbers. So we need to send this into a quadrature modulator. So remember, quadrature modulator takes here these complex values and multiplies this with the carrier frequency. So that's our carrier frequency, and then after that we can transmit that. So the quadrature modulator transforms this baseband signal here, so that's our baseband. And remember, we've defined the bandwidth of the baseband with the help of our frequency coefficients here, the number we are actually using and not setting to zero. And so here what's coming out here is a bandpass modulated signal. So remember here, this looked in proper drawing notation with negative frequencies. If this is here our F, and this is here x of f, then this was here our bandwidth b, and then obviously we also have we've got negative frequencies here. Quadrature modulator continued. So and so here what we're here doing is, so we run FC at the lowest possible frequency. So what does that mean at the lowest possible frequency? The lowest possible frequency is essentially double the sampling rate of our complex time series. So the idea is, so we take our complex time series. Yeah, so what is coming out of our inverse Fourier transform? And obviously this one has a real and an imaginary part, and we interleave them within two samples. So we take our complex time series, so like this, and we interleave real and imaginary parts. We do this in the following way, that we say, okay, so our xn turns it into real, imaginary, and then into minus real, minus imaginary, and then into real again, and into imaginary. And this is then here one x of n, and this is here x of n plus 1, and this is here x of n plus 2, and so on. So the question is now, so why does it make sense? So we say that fs mod, so the sampling rate of our modulator, that's 2 times the sampling rate of our complex symbols. So that's the sampling rate of the IFFT, or our complex symbols. And the output sampling rate of our modulator. So that's the output of the modulator. That's two times the frequency. So remember, so we've got here our IFFT, and we've got our stream here x of n. So this is here at fs, and then here we've got our quadrature modulator. And then this output here, this is at 2 times fs. So 2 times sampling rate here, because we're interleaving real and imaginary values. And so the interesting thing is now, so which frequency are we using here for our quadrature modulator? And in relative frequencies, this runs at 0.25 for the carrier. In normalized frequencies. So this means that one period is 4 samples.